Hi guys, today we have with us Shefali. So Shefali have got all IM calls, all matlab jo bhi call aaya, she got the calls and she converted every call she have got. So Chaya, we would first like to start with your background, where you are from and what would be in your academic record and all, so that we can then move on.
Okay, so my name is Shefali Chaya and currently I'm in Delhi. I've been born and brought up in Delhi. So I did my schooling from Bhatnagar International. I passed out in 2015. So I had science in my 10th and 12th, you know, in 11th and 12th. However, after that, I went on to doing something different. So I did not want to pursue the, you know, typical streams that are available. So since my father is also in the same field, I went on to pursuing my Bachelor of Arts in Tourism Administration from Amity. And I got 88 percentile in that. So that's a first division with distinction. And so this was a little bit off topic, you know, this is not something field that usually people pursue, or they even like, most of people are not even aware that, you know, there is a course, aisa koi course exist bhi karta hai. So I was always questioned ki yaar tumhare paas science tha, acha percentile bhi tha, aisa kuch nahi tha ki padhai mein acche nahi ho, to phir engineer. So I was like, this is not what I want to do, this is not my calling, you know. In the college, I was a very active student, say in terms, because it was a practical experiences. So sare events mein participate karna, chahe wo college ke ho ya bahar ho. So I would, you know, participate a lot, organizing committee and everything. And academics was strong as well. So post that, I graduated in June 2018. And then I worked 9 months in a travel agency as a travel consultant. And then, so I gave, then I left after like a month because I wanted to, I had to do an MBA since a very long time. But I wanted to gain a little bit experience and then go towards the education. So then I switched to Doordarshan. Currently, I'm working there in Doordarshan Sports in Delhi. So I work there in the social media team and I'm also their anchor. So I've anchored at a lot of, you know, Doordarshan channels. Yeah.
I'm trying to think about that. Superb.
Yeah. So that's the background that I have.
And I think that could be one of the main reasons why you converted all of them. Because you are coming from a very different, like typical kya, BCom engineer, BMS, BCom BMS engineer. And suddenly you coming into picture, I think that was very exciting for the interviewers as well. They are willing to talk something new. Like they're talking to anchor kind of thing. So that obviously might have helped you in the end. Obviously it's your hard work. So Shefali, today's interview, I want to focus on more of your converting interviews rather than getting a call. How to convert the call, that is what I want to focus on. Yep. So that's what we are going to talk mainly about. So first we'll quickly talk about your preparation strategy for 2-3 minutes, then we'll jump into the interview skills part. So when you started preparing for MBA?
So sir, since I told you I did not have maths in my you know, undergraduation or in my 11th or 12th, so I had a knowledge that you know, this might be the section that I would have to work a little more upon. And so that's why I started a preparation a little early than usually people do. So I started it in Jan 2019. And also I started it this early, you know, starting in 2019, because I was also working along with my preparation. So I had to do it side by side. So I think I knew that I had a weaker section at quant, so I tried to focus more on that. So say on weekends when I'm not working, I would try to, you know, focus on that. And I started from the scratch, like because kuch maths nahi aata tha, bahut dar tha, to started from the scratch. 10th ki NCRT nikali, 11th ki NCRT nikali, ekdam basic se shuru kara sir, sab kuch. And you know, starting I learned all the fractions and multiplication to speed up my calculations, because I had completely lost touch with my you know, mathematics. And then what I did is, what I started off with arithmetic. So, you know, say percentages, profit loss, sare easy topics jo uske sath main comfortable thi, maine wo pehle kare. बट आई मेड श्योर कि अगर मैं कोई यू नो से आई एम कम्प्लीटिंग सिंपल इंटरेस्ट और कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट तो मैं वो टॉपिक एकदम छोड़ ही ना दूं. आई वुड यू नो डू इट प्रैक्टिस इट ऑन अ रेगुलर बेसिस एंड आई स्टार्टेड ऑफ विद द इजी टॉपिक्स देन मीडियम एंड सर ऐसे हुआ था कि बहुत बार आई वुड यू नो गेट स्टक बहुत सारी चीजों में बिल्कुल समझ ही नहीं आता था कि अरे ये आया तो कहाँ से आंसर आया. So I, you know, I took help from my friends who had maths. Took you know, I literally took you know, like say I would get stuck and I would actually call up my brother who's actually in class 11th and I would say, "Yar, ye kaise hua? Tu mere ko bata." Because I really want to know ki hua kaise. So that's what the thing. I did not want to just let it go. And for the English, sir, I was always very comfortable with English because of reading newspapers. So initially I started off with making a habit of daily reading newspapers. हिंदू का editorial के बिना तो सर दिन नहीं शुरू करती थी. Made sure कि जो भी words नहीं समझ आ रहे हैं उसी time underline करके उसके meanings देखे. And for English I would say कि it's good to read a lot of diverse topics. So after you know reading a lot of diverse topics and actually giving mocks is when you understand कि आप कौन से topics के साथ you know comfortable हो. So I tend, you know, create a tendency out of that. And then sir, VA, VA, I think nothing but just practice because there's nothing actually you can, you know, there are no concepts as such. Then coming to VA, the LRDI, I was, you know, I had a little bit of understanding that logical reasoning would be comfortable for me because I had given a mock starting me ekdam preparation shuru karne se pehle, I gave a mock. कि बस देना है और देखना है अपना क्या स्टैंड है एग्जैक्टली. ऑब्वियसली उसमें स्कोर तो बहुत अच्छा नहीं आया था बट अंडरस्टैंडिंग हो गया था कि कहां है.
हाउ मच यू स्कोर्ड इन दैट मॉक?
ऑनेस्टली सर आई स्कोर्ड आई थिंक 42 और 43 इन दैट.
एंड बट बैच हु देयर इज वन मोर गाय आई इंटरव्यूड हिम हु इज जॉइनिंग योर बैच ही गॉट 7% इन द फर्स्ट मॉक 7% फ्रॉम 7 टू ऑब्वियसली यार बिना पढ़े दोगे तो कहां से स्कोर आएगा ऑब्वियसली.
Yes, sir. Yes, definitely. So, mera to I scored a negative in my first mock in maths. So, matlab, but I knew that aisa hai. So, the thing is to actually understand ki aapke weak areas kya hai and actually to work upon them and practice side by side also practicing your stronger areas. So, sir, VA, sorry, LRDI mein kya kara tha? Obviously, practice. Nothing, there's nothing that actually works. खाली प्रैक्टिस करा कैलकुलेशंस थोड़ा स्टार्ट करना और करा एंड देन ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम पता चल गया कि ये वाले मेरे स्ट्रॉन्ग सेट्स है. सो आई व्हेन आई एक्चुअली वेंट टू कैट पहले पूरा पेपर स्क्रॉल कर लिया देख लिया कि क्या 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 आता है एंड देन फिर उसके बाद उसको स्टार्ट करा. बट ओवरऑल इन माई होल कैट पेपर एंड इन माई मॉक्स ऑल्सो आई मेड श्योर कि आई वुड डू द क्वेश्चंस ओनली दैट आई एम श्योर ऑफ. तो मतलब एक भी तुक्का नहीं मारा या एक भी ऐसा क्वेश्चन नहीं अटेम्प्ट करा जिसके लिए मैं अनश्योर थी सो दैट मेरे मार्क्स नेगेटिव में ना जाएं. एंड कहीं भी स्टक नहीं हुई सर. बहुत सारे ऐसे मतलब हो जाते हैं ना हमको कि यार ये सेट तो मेरे को आता था हमेशा मैं करती थी अभी क्यों नहीं हो रहा है. तो उसमें स्टक नहीं हुई. आई मेड श्योर कि एक सेट पे 10 से 12 मिनट लगा के आगे मूव ऑन कर
जाऊंगा.
So I had Ahmedabad for CAT. I had Ahmedabad, Bangalore, Lucknow, Kozhikode, Shillong, and all the new and the baby IIMs.
Calcutta nahi hai.
Nahi, I did not get. I remember asking you also that.
क्यों नहीं आया कलकत्ता? यार this is the main problem I get. People ask me, तो यार मुझे जब IIM कलकत्ता वाला जॉब नहीं दे पा रहा तो मैं कैसे जॉब दूंगा यार? But I have to give some answer. So I always say कि बाकी जो कॉल है भैया वो संभालो जाने दो जो नहीं अभी जाने दो.
So because it becomes very unpredictable for us also कि cutoffs clear हो गए हैं academic background भी अच्छा है कोई gap year भी नहीं था सब मेरी तो profile भी इतनी diverse थी and then sir जब आपको अहमदाबाद का कॉल आ जाए बाकियों का कॉल आ जाए and then suddenly एक कॉल ना आए तो वो थोड़ा setback हो जाता है एकदम से.
ऊपर से Indian mentality, yeah, I have got 10, but 11th, why not 11th? I want to see all of them in the plane. Great, super, sir, super.
I remember already converting IIM Ahmedabad. Results were out, I had already converted. But I remember sitting for all the other interviews also because sare apna wo hota hai na satisfaction ki sare convert karne hai mere ko.
Nice, superb, yeah, superb, superb. So before you comment, I want to ask everybody else which college he should take. I'm Ahmedabad, I'm Bangalore, I'm Indore. So which one you think she should take? Let people comment. And why? Obviously, that's more important. Why? So okay, now what's your answer for that? Why I'm Ahmedabad?
I think for me, it was very clear when I actually stepped into the interview also. And before that also, because sir, coming from a diverse background, that was the only interview where I thought the interview panel was genuinely interested into me. Rather than, you know, so whichever interview else that I got into, they were always like, ki, are MBA hi kyun karna hai? Kuch aur kyun nahi karte ho? Ye kyun nahi karte ho? You know, but at IIM Ahmedabad, they were very interested. Like, you know, they were like fascinated and they're like, oh, wow, you're coming from a diverse background. So tell us about that. Tell us about this destination. But I was always, you know, I was also shocked by seeing the fact that the professors actually, you know, they went into practicality also. So they asked me to design an itinerary right then and there in the interview. And they covered all the aspects from anchoring also, what are the drawbacks and what you actually learned from it. So everything. So I think that's it.
That's why they are at IIM Ahmedabad. That's why they are at IIM Ahmedabad.
Right. Yes, sir.
So, matlab, yeah, this year, what I've seen is IIM Ahmedabad was not at all stressful interview. They are going into the depth, but they're not putting people into a lot of stress. Like till earlier, almost 50% of aspirants used to come out with a crying or sad feeling that they were literally bombarded with questions. But this time they were light, even for you as well. The panelists were kind of a light mood.
Or made so, definitely. So my panel was very friendly, and I think also because I was never really scared. So I was scared of CAT, but I was not really scared of the interviews. So mere dimag mein hamesha se tha ki ek bar call aa gaya, fir to main convert kar lungi. Itna I had a confidence in myself. But interview panel se bhi sir, I remember ek do questions nahi aaye the. So kafi, you know, because there's so much of pressure and, you know, everything is just dependent on one interview. So it's just human nature to, you know, stumble and you do that. So I remember saying something wrong also. And the interview panel just, you know, they smiled and they said, no, this is wrong, but it's okay. We'll continue.
Superb, superb. Okay, now tell us three things which you think you have, which help you convert all the calls.
So I think initially I was very skeptical of this because we always, you know, hear that diversity ke extra marks milte hain or IIMs are looking for diversity, but on ground reality you always see that, you know, 80% engineers hain, 70% engineers hain, ya tumhare aas paas sab BCom BBA wale log baithe hain, so you start self doubting. But I think the first thing was I was very you know, sure that what I wanted to do. So in my interview also, they asked me post my MBA, what are my plans? They in depth asked me, what is the business plan that you want to follow? What is the job? So I was very sure of what I wanted to do and why MBA is the right choice. And secondly, I think the communication skills. So, you know, we've heard ki bahut sare logo ka 99 aa jata hai, 98 aa jata hai, but they fail to convert the call. So that's because of their communication skills, which is important. I mean, whichever background you come from, that is definitely it. And then the third thing was I prepared really nicely from my interview. So starting from my background, academics, my work experience, general awareness, I mean, koi bhi question jo koi thought kar sakta, matlab, they can actually think, wo maine pen down karke acche se uske liye prepare kara tha, so that from my end, main bahut zyada, you know, prepared thi. So I think those are the three things that actually helped me convert.
Superb. So if we get into the detail of these three things, I think number three point you prepared. This is my problem. People are willing to spend 2 years to prepare for the CAT exam, but they're not willing to spend even 1 week for the preparation for the interviews. This is a fundamental problem which everyone thinking now they're overconfident. Okay, I'm 20, I'm called 10, I'm called, they're posting everywhere, but they're not putting in the enough effort. This is what I've seen. So you answered that rightly, because you have to write down all the answers. Even though you are very good with comm skills, your profile is strong, but still you did the hard work. Yeah, so that is number one point, which obviously I recommend to everyone. I'll recommend them to learn from you about this thing. Number two, you said ki comm skills. Okay, now you have got excellent comm skills, but how can a person like me can improve that? Suppose I got a call today, so today in, let's say, January 15th, a call aa jayega. So January 15th to February 15th, we got around 1 month ka time to prepare for the interviews. So, A, what I should be doing in that 1 month, yeah, to become your junior at IIM Ahmedabad, if I've got the call. Or number two is what I should do from now only to improve, so that I don't need to bank everything on the Jan and Kamant.
So, Hello.
Yeah, so there are two questions in total.
Okay. So, starting off with the first question, I think as I stated earlier, it's very, very important that people actually read newspapers every day. So, only when you are confident with your knowledge, that you are aware of all the things that are happening around you, then only you can be sure that you won't stumble upon, or, you know, your communication skills will be right at point. And then the other thing is, for interviews, I think it's very important to give mock interviews. So necessarily you don't have to join like a coaching center or something like that. You can just ask your friend. Or I remember telling my office mentors also, ki ma'am break hai abhi, aap 15 minute tak mera interview le loge. So is during this situation bahut sare aise accept nahi karte ho, expect nahi karte ho, but they actually come. So I think that, and actually not just reading, but actually understanding what the paragraph or the news has to say. So agar kuch cheez nahi samajh aa raha hai, uska immediately meaning samajhna, and start using it in your daily language. Ek mahine ke liye you can maybe try and talk in English to your relatives, your friends. So wo habit ban jata hai, then it comes to you naturally.
Superb. One thing I really liked what you said was, if your content is strong, if you work on the content, then your even if you have weak comm skills, your confidence will automatically come.
Yes, sir. Definitely.
Superb. Superb. Okay. Do I need to do something from now onwards? But like now, from August onward, I need to improve my comm skills, or something I need to work on my profile, or you think after the calls also I can improve?
So I think so already what you've done in the past is your academic score and all that cannot be, changed. So things that you can work on is firstly trying to maximize your CAT score so that you get the calls that you want. And I would not say ki communication ko backseat de dena chahiye. So it's kind of like a continuous process. It's not something that you magically get within a click. So continuously usko saath saath work upon karna chahiye.
Yes.
With focusing on candidates, but once the calls are out, I think you should put all your hard work into actually converting it. Not be overconfident ki ab sare calls aa gaye hain, koi na koi to ho jayega. That should not be the attitude that you should follow.
Right. True. So, any other experience you had at any of the IIMs which is worth mentioning? Something very odd happened, or something very stupid happened, or you did some stupidity in the interview, but still you survived.
I wouldn't say anything stupid happened, but I always remember, people around me that were coming for interviews, or I met during the time of my, people will always say, are arts background se hai, inme to dimag hi nahi hota hai itna, ye toh bane nahi hai aptitude test ke liye and all that. So I remember people saying all of these things. But it's very important that you don't let all these things affect you, and you maintain your confidence. And as for the interview, sir, I remember in my IIMA interview only, so they asked me ki pichle ek saal mein what are the landmark judgment that had been passed by the Supreme Court. And I ended up saying CAA bill, which was actually not passed by the Supreme Court. So this was something, that actually slipped out of my mind, but the interview panels were kind enough to let it go as a first time thing, and we continued later on.
So what you did, you just said sorry about this, or you apologized and moved on, or how you handled the situation at that time? Because this can make or break the thing. If you don't say sorry, or if you are very adamant at your stand, so it might break the case as well. So how to handle these kind of situations?
So I will tell you two different scenarios that actually happened in two of my different IIM interviews. In this one, since I knew that I had done it wrong, and at that time I was a little unsure that maybe it is wrong. And the panel told me that, you know, what you're saying is wrong. So I apologized. I said, I'm sorry. You know, this was my mistake. And then I started on with a different case, you know. So I told them about the Sabarimala temple and I continuously switched. So it's like basically I'm apologizing also for what I did. But I'm also telling them that, yes, I know a different thing that you're asking me. And then the second case would be it was my stress interview. So it was at IMK. And I remember there was two interview, people in the interview panel. And one of the sir had not spoken in the entire interview. And suddenly he goes like, you know, who's the lieutenant governor of Delhi? And I say, Mr. Anil Bajaj. And he goes like, no, you're wrong. And I was like, no, sir, I think I'm sure. He's like, no, no, no. And then suddenly he started shouting, ki Delhi wale ho, governor nahi pata hai yahan ka and all that, kuch nahi aata hai, tumhare ko dekhna main wait list mein dal. To my point, because of the fact that I knew that I was right. But if I was unsure, I should have, you know, said sorry. But since I was, very confident, I stayed adamant to my part. Because, you know, I think the interview panels, sometimes they try to create a stress situation to see how actually you rely, you know, throw back it at and how confident are you with.
All right, right. So you were stuck to your stand, hey, sir, I'm right at all. You said that.
Yes,
okay.
Sir. Yes.
Great, great.
I mean, I wasn't. I wouldn't like put it like ki main ekdam sahi hu, but right. I told them. So I think I'm strong. I am sure of what I'm saying, and I would like to stick to my answer. I told him that very politely.
Right, right, right. Normally, what I would say, sir, I think it was right, but I will go home and check. After this, I'll go home and check once again. Maybe something you can ghuma do.
So actually, this thing happened because I was 200% sure of this thing. I was very stuck on my point, but I remember the interview panel ending my interview saying ki abhi jaake Google pe check karna, aur agar galat aaya na, to abhi se samajh jana ki you are in the reject list.
Oh shit.
But I ended up converting that call as well.
Okay, superb. Now this is their way to put stress on you, how do you handle the stress? So okay, yeah. Now this is a lot of time happening. I'm Calcutta interview as well, that you're not able to answer. So what to do in that case? What you did in that case? Suppose you don't know the answer. So you just politely say, no sir, I don't know the answer, or you give some excuse, or what is your, like suppose if I ask you who is a China ka third rank person, I don't know what to call it, who is the third, which you don't know the answer. So what will you, how will you react to that?
I think it's not like in an interview, you're supposed to answer all of it, because I'm sure there's nobody who can answer everything, surely. It's just how you maintain your confidence. So I think when you don't know an answer, whether it's from your academics or general awareness, it's good to take a backseat, tell that sir or ma'am, I'm sorry, I'm not aware of this thing. I will go home and read about it, but maybe you can ask something from another area. So you can state an area that you are stronger about. So I think that's how you tackle, and don't let yourself be down ki a question nahi answer kar paaye to, ab to interview gaya. This is not the way. So I think it's important to stay strong, stay confident, and just say that you don't know the answer.
Great, great. One thing I'd like to add, you said the panel said you are rejected or you are put in the wait list. So please try to understand, this is for all the audience who is going to watch this video, okay, they have no rights to decide whether to take it or not to take it. They are only there to give you marks. So what they can do maximum is reduce your marks or increase your marks. So your interview is not in their hand. So the moment you start thinking that, when your confidence level goes up, कि बॉस ये मेरे को मार्क्स देगा, बस कम ज्यादा मार्क्स देगा, एंड इफ माय कैट स्कोर इज गुड, इफ माय एकेडमिक रिकॉर्ड इज गुड, आई कैन इजीली कवर अप द गैप. सो दैट कैन फील यू, गिव यू अ मोटिवेशन काइंड ऑफ थिंग इन द इंटरव्यू. सो
या दैट्स ट्रू सर.
या ग्रेट. सो एनीथिंग यू लाइक टू ऐड? ओके, माय लास्ट टिपिकल क्वेश्चन, हाउ सीके हेल्प्ड यू इन दिस जर्नी?
Sir, so I wasn't because I am in Delhi and apka base is mainly in Maharashtra. So I could not take the normal classes. If I would have been in Maharashtra, surely. But I think you played a very important role in, you know, keeping my confidence. So as I told, because I come from an arts background and it was very tough for me because sometimes even you break your self-confidence. Ki yaar, sab bol rahe hai, toh hoga ki nahi hoga. But I remember I gave a mock and I scored badly in it. So, you know, matlab, English aise tha, VR aise tha, sab kuch achha achha tha, and then maths ekdam niche tha. So I remember you putting out a video for all the non-engineers and, you know, ekdam, it was like right on point. So I think that's how it helped me motivated from the starting till the end, whether it was for my preparation or anything. And also personally also, sir, thank you. I mean, you were very kind enough to always be there. You know, I pinged you saying ki ye nahi ho raha, wo nahi ho raha, and you always replied. So I think that's something that I will always remember, sir.
So sweet of you. So sweet of you. So abhi hum party karenge, I'm Ahmedabad jaake. So I do come to the campus every year. So hope to see you soon there. So I'll meet you there.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Definitely.
Thank you, Shefali. Thank you very much for coming online and talking to us.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.